Today we're going to talk about the Sabbat of Beltane and celebrate it by building a magical fairy ring. Beltane is the festival of life. It's the celebration of the onset of summer, believe it or not. And we always tend to celebrate summer as the summer solstice, but the summer solstice is actually the peak of summer. Beltane, on the other hand, is when everything really starts to blossom and grow, hence the name Festival of Life. With a Beltane festival, we are celebrating the earth waking back up. It's finally warm, we can finally go outside. Beltane is basically the onset of the light half of the year. We are outside, it's warm, things are growing and blossoming. So all of the seeds that we planted during the dark half of the year, all the things that we've decided to manifest, come to fruition during the light half of the year. Beltane is kind of like the pagan kickoff. Often this is the first Sabbat that we like to celebrate outdoors because the weather is not always conducive to it before Beltane. 6 months apart from that would be Samhain, which most people know as Halloween, and that would be the festival of death, everything going back to sleep, the ancestors waking up and going into the dark half of the year. So being as those two are directly across from each other 6 months apart, they are called the greater Sabbats because they have the greatest energetic shifts of the year. One of my very favorite things to do during Beltane is to build a fairy ring. Fairies kind of represent all of nature waking back up and popping and coming to life, maybe a little bit of mischief, a little bit of fun. It's all about bringing that happiness and just that whimsical quality back into our lives. This is something that you can set up outside to honor all of that earth energy coming back to life. They are created in nature. You look for areas where natural circles or rings have formed. Perhaps formations of flowers. You look for formations of maybe a little ring of mushrooms. This particular spot, you can actually see a circular formation of the grass. So I thought that this would be a perfect place to build a fairy ring. It happens to be in one of my favorite spots in the backyard, right in front of the cauldron. When building a fairy ring, it's kind of like building a grid. Like if you've ever built a crystal grid, because what you're doing is you're trying to concentrate energy into a certain area. The best way to start is to get your four directions. So I find stuff for a fairy ring that I think is fun and whimsical, but also represents that particular element. For earth, of course, there's going to be some stones, there's going to be some plants. I got a little gnome over there. For water, I'm going to make sure that I have some things to represent the water element, but it's also a very feminine element, so I try to give it a nice cool and calming effect. For fire, it's a little bit more direct and intense, so we have some things over there to represent that. And then, of course, for air, which is all of the imaginative and light qualities, things that spark some inspiration. I like to take time collecting that, and it usually takes a few weeks. I wait for something to catch my attention, and I make sure that the energy is just right. It has to harmonize. You can't just bring anything out here. I've done it before. It does not work. Nature will tell me it does not belong. I will get like the wind will start to blow in the wrong direction. Stuff will just start falling in my way, or I'll trip a lot. A lot of people will say, well, that's the fairies tripping you, telling you that you don't want it in there. Kind of creating a sacred space. I want to make sure that it's a fun place to be for me, because if it's not fun for me, it's not going to be fun for the energy that's coming in. This has to be a pleasurable place, a peaceful place, and also a place that I want to bring magical objects to be blessed by nature. My fairy rings actually get used all year, just before May. I start building it, and it's basically an offering for the entire month where it's going to look very magical and whimsical in this way. However, the energy always exists. So once the fairy ring is taken down, it's a place where I will do any libations after a spell, if there's anything left over and I want to offer it. If I'm making a special spray or potion, all of my magical bottles and really specialty items that I've made go in the center of the fairy ring to be blessed. I will also do some of my most powerful and profound rituals inside a fairy ring. I do like to draw down the moon inside my fairy ring. During Samhain, which is exactly 6 months from Beltane, I will take the potions that I make for the year and I will bless them inside the fairy ring as they're being made. It's a year-round project, but it is celebrated the most around the Sabbat of Beltane. Beltane is very well hidden, but it is definitely a part of our modern culture. It is celebrated in a lot of different ways. You may know it as May Day. It's the 1st of May, where the maypole comes out and everybody dances around the maypole. That is one of the big celebrations of Beltane. It is something that has been adopted by a lot of cultures because it's a beautiful time to go outside and celebrate nature. The maypole actually represents the male and the female energy coming together, the pole being the masculine energy and the crown of flowers at the top representing the feminine energy. So those two come together to create the beautiful dance of the creation of nature. Anything that is in season during this time of year would be used. I'm always very heavy leaning into is anything with strawberries in it. I love a good strawberry shortcake at this time. The mead comes out a lot at that time as well. And mead is a honey wine. May wine, which is made with a lot of the sacred herbs of this time, such as woodruff, has a very light, sweet quality because the sweetness of the earth is coming back. May is just a very special time for me. My wedding anniversary is actually on Beltane. And my birthday is at the end of the month, so I kind of feel like I own May. So that's why the fairy ring is very, very close to my heart, because I know that as I'm building this, it's also celebrating me as well, which is what we should do when we celebrate these things. We should bring ourselves into these celebrations. They should mean something to us. We have to connect with all of these things in some way. Otherwise, the magic is not there.